I'm Siti Amina, the main vocalist in Siti the Band, but also an oud player and also the leader of Siti the Band. My music when I was in my mother's womb. When I opened my eyes and starting to knowing myself, I noticed myself, I really love dancing. I really love music, so I started with dancing. There's no ceremony at home happen without me in the middle dancing. So that's why I started. And then slowly, pole, there was my cousin also started to sing. I think music is in our family blood, but we didn't notice. There's no great singer, but my auntie's singing a lot at home. It was tough for my society. You know, it reaches a time when I was about 12, we had to stop. And I know why, because what our neighbors starting to say to our family, like, we're still young. We are the girls, why did you allow them? So we stop.
This song, it says nielewe, which means understand in my Swahili language. It's my personal story, but the story of most African women, how we suffer. How we suffer from beating from our husband. Naomba mwelewe. Wanaume wa hii dunia, hizi sio zile karne. Karne za ujahilia, mwatutwanga kama ngoma, hata kufikiria mwanamke ndiyo mama na pepo katika hii dunia. Special dedication to all the men around the world who beat women. I suffer. I don't allow any women to suffer more. Women is a flower, it's a beautiful wife. It's your sister, it's your mama. Why did you beat? Let's change the world together. Let's change to go. Let's change our world together, because I believe together we can make it.
When I finished my studies, when I was like 19, I said to myself, okay, now it's my time. But suddenly I met with a man. In our society, when you're young, you just met a man, you just promise each other to get married faster. We said, okay, let's get married. But I explaining to him my dream. He said, okay, I also love music, so I will support you. Then we get married. After we get married, I said, let me start. He didn't want any. He said, okay, let's after we get birth. After I get birth, it was the same thing. He refused it. When my boy gets like 1 year and a half, there was a competition announced, searching for talents in Tanzania. I said, this is my time to go. And then I go myself without telling my husband. I win on top five for Zanzibar. The day I step on this competition is the day we have a very argument with the fighting inside. So I decided to take my boy and return back home, Zanzibar, and join the only music academy in Zanzibar. That is the place where makes me to be Siti Amina today and get my knowledge of musical education, music cultures in the world. That is where we met each other, Siti the Band. When you talk about Zanzibar, it's a mix of different cultures in the world. But our last ruler was Sultan from Oman. It was Arabic. So in Zanzibar, we have influence of Arabic most. 99% we are Muslims. So the things of qanun and ouds and violin is a part of Zanzibar culture now, you see. But also, before that, there was no music academy. The musicians were taught by themselves by hearing and imitating. But now we have a music academy, so youngest like us, we're getting opportunity to learn traditional instruments, you see. But for women, women's only singing. So when I joined the music academy, I said, now it's my time. I see that gap of women doing instruments. So that's why I decided to take oud. And my cousin, Rahma, in my band, decided to take violin. When you talk about Muslims, it's a very huge topic. Music is forbidden for men, for women, especially for women for playing. It's most difficult, you see. For Zanzibar, you can even lose the husband if you're involved in music. Until today, we get a challenge. I'm Muslim and I love being Muslim. But God says everything can be sin. It depends what you do, how you do. When we started, it was very, very difficult, you see. Day by day, when we're like, let's keep on doing. Right now, the family already support us. Like the dresses we are wearing, like on the show, the dress was created by our auntie, you see. So we have a very huge support in the family. But then the society starts to understand. We preserve a culture, even the government. They support us right now. Even the society love our music. So changes needs time, slowly. So we believe Zanzibar will change. My life can be on the way of music also. It's my healing. So my biggest dream is music to be my life, but also my dream to other women in my society to be free with music. to express themselves, to live in the life they're free because of music, like I live right now. That's my biggest dream. As a woman, we need to fight. It reaches the time right now. We need to fight by our own. We need to stand up and fight for our rights. It doesn't matter any society you are in, to stand up and sing whatever you want to do. You can follow your believing while you stand up and expressing yourself out, whatever by singing, whatever by speaking. You have to be the one to say, it's time for me to change, it's time for me to get up and stand up.
Thank you.